Welcome to Amber Rock Station. Far out in the frontier, nestled in a highly geothermally active valley, this hydroelectric power plant extracts both energy and rare minerals from local geysers and hot springs. The ECHO organization works in conjunction with Amber Rock to repair and terraform the local ecosystem. This ensures that the area is suited to support its most important facilities, the training grounds for the Apex Legends. For the first time, Amber Rock is opening these attractions to the public. Guests can help keep the power flowing in Watson's Tesla Coiler, carry out a combat flight in Valkyrie's Pilot Academy, feel the adrenaline in Octane's Extravaganza, and experience being rescued by Wraith, Crypto, and Mirage in the escape from Sing Labs. Amber Rock Station is also home to the Salvo Slammers, the Duo Showdown, and much, much more. Whether you want to feel what it's like to be an Apex Legend or dine in style in Loba's Cruiser Casino, Amber Rock has everything you need to have the perfect Apex experience. Stay tuned or use the timestamps below for an in-depth look at the newest and onlyest addition to Peony Plains Theme Park. All right, I am so stoked to finally be able to share this with you. Welcome to Amber Rock Station, my Planet Coaster Apex Legends Fusion theme park. Coming through the entrance tunnel, we get our first glimpse of the station as a whole. We have the main hydroelectric power plant way off in the distance. If we step up to the map though, we can get a nice little hint as to where we want to go. There are 13 different rides and attractions, but there are other shops and restaurants themed around Legends as well. We can see one of the geyser harvesters that I built here. The park is closed for now while I do the tour so I can stay above 2 frames a second, but if it was open, this building here is a gift shop with a restaurant upstairs. Moving towards our first stop, though, is Watson's Tesla Coiler. The front facade is themed around one of the Hammond launch sites from World's Edge, with a lot of my own twists thrown in there. We can see here one of my custom signs that I built, 35 minutes for standard, 15 minutes for express. Pretty good wait time, not gonna lie. The express line we're not gonna go down. The main line is our focus here because it's the one that's decorated the most. This queue line has a lot of theming around electricity and Tesla coils. Obviously, if I had had the ability to create Watson animatronics, I would have loved to make them to explain the theme of the ride, which is that the riders have to sit in the spinning cars to weigh them down so that they can charge Watson's tech, whatever she's working on. We can see in both the windows that she's working on her fences, setting up new technology that way, but riders are supposed to be the ones that are physically helping her keep everything running. And up here, we have the main station with Watson's Tesla Coiler, allons-y. So yeah, let's go, first ride.
Aisle leads away. Feels that charge in the air. Let's go! Allons-y! Charge!
All right, love that ride. It was my first one that I ever built, kind of the proof of concept, like, can I actually make an Apex park? And yeah, turns out I could. We have a little area out here where people can eat, because outside on these upper two levels we have a little French restaurant and then a drink shop on the left side, and then stairs back down to the main path for everybody. Heading back out to the main path now, we're gonna take a left here, turn the other way, get a nice view of that main power plant again, and head up to Valkyrie's Pilot Academy. I myself am a Valkyrie main, so this ride took me forever, and it was the first one that I actually got burnt out on. But coming back to it and actually finishing it gave me all the motivation I needed to finish the entire park. So I love this ride for a lot of different reasons. Gonna swing around here and give you one of my favorite views in the park is the view of this tower from this entrance plaza with the Valkyrie sign. You may have spotted the little restaurant hut on the right that feeds the people in the plaza. There's sushi and another drink stop up here for Valkyrie, which is super tight. Heading inside though, we can see the first main foyer for the attraction. We've got the hat shop on the one side for the gift shop for like little knickknacks and doodly dads. And then this couch here, I actually downloaded custom pieces to have beer bottles and food so you can kind of get the hint that that's where Valkyrie likes to hang out and chill while she's in here watching her cadets take off. But going in here, this is the first part of the queue. Not gonna go through the priority queue. It's not decorated any more than this is. I really like this view, like the tint on the glass, and then in here we get a pretty solid view of the trains as they get to leave the hangar and they taxi out onto the runway, which I think is pretty cool. I really think that I packed as much detail in here as I could without totally tanking my frame rate, which is the goal for the whole park. As you can see, this part of the queue, not decorated at all because the only thing that would fit on the walls were like pipes and things, and it's not really worth it if it's gonna cost me 2 frames in the future, if that makes sense. But out here, we have the perfect bird's eye view of the whole park. I love that you can actually stand in front of these windows as you're in line and look out at the whole park. It's perfect for Valkyrie's line. Continuing on though, we go down this little tower now, and there's also windows at the front of this. As soon as we round this corner here, let me get around. As soon as we round this, we can look out here and you can see that guests at this part of the queue can look out and watch the trains launch, go up, and then come down and race right underneath them, which is, again, super tight. Love it. Really happy with how it turned out. This is where the priority pass queue meets the main queue, and then we get to go into the station. And here we are for our second ride and probably my personal favorite.
Alert 5, Valkyrie on station, we are go for burn. Make sure seat backs, tray tables, and automatic weapons are in their full upright positions. Runway's green as grass, and we are ready for takeoff in 10. Squadrons, all that in a bag of chips. All in a day's work. Landing gear's down, let's bring her home. Circling the runway a bit. Tango Delta. The captain's turned off the no seatbelt sign. You're free to move about the Outlands.
Alrighty, and moving on. Oh my god, I'm so happy with the way that that ride turned out. I think Valkyrie's voice lines fit so perfectly for what I needed. I was so stoked on how it felt, on how it just like, it made you feel like you were flying along with Valkyrie. I thought, whatever. I love that ride. It makes me so happy. It gave me so much motivation. But continuing back down this path here, we can see another one of the geyser collectors on the left, and then we're going across this main bridge to the rest of the park, really. Well, it's one of the routes to the rest of the park. We have a nice view on the right and the left, seeing the entrance, and then also seeing the Pathfinder Plaza that we're headed to at the moment. But yeah, I love this bridge. I think it turned out so clean. If you recognize it, it's the roof of one of the lava siphon buildings on World's Edge, just scaled down a little bit. This bridge offers a great panoramic view of the entirety of Amber Rock Station, but we've got a tour to complete, so we can push across into probably my favorite World's Edge building that I made, which is the entrance to the Pathfinder Plaza. You can see up at the top, there's glass, you can see up to Valkyrie's runways, and then up here, there's another great view of the hydroelectric power plant. But we're not headed there quite yet. We get to just push down into these pathways here and then around the corner, but of course, taking the view again. And then on the left here, we have Pathfinder Plaza, where we have Pathfinder Stunt Swinger. I know that says spinner on the sign. Ignore that. The reason why will become apparent in a bit. But if we continue in here, we can see the queue building. I didn't go too crazy on the decorations in here. Anytime where I don't, I'll explain later, actually. Let's get on this ride for now. Alrighty, done with Pathfinder Stunt Swinger, positively nauseated. Some of you might be wondering why not every legend gets their own custom-themed roller coaster, and the reason is literally just logistical stuff, like I don't have room for a coaster for everybody, but I thought that ride fit, because there were several instances in the cinematics where Pathfinder was piloting things, so having him be in charge of the Stunt Swinger, which is set in the little, you know, sci-fi fighter, felt appropriate. From this angle, we can also see a zip line that leads to Pathfinder Plaza, which will come into play a little later. And looking up at the hydroelectric power plant, we now get to go inside for the first time, where we can see the cafeteria slash galley for some of the workers over here. We've got some hot dogs and other things for folks to eat. And then through this window, we can see our first glimpse at Ash's snare spinner. Not Swinger. That's why I had to rename the other ride, but never changed the sign, unfortunately. But yeah, in here for Ash's Snare Spinner, it's not that popular of a flat ride. I know it isn't. The guests just never seem to ride it, never seem to like it, but with this ride, it goes around in a circle, so of course I wanted to make it look like a massive generator. So if we look at the ride and flip it into testing, like so, Or, wow, I guess it was halfway through its cycle. Basically, the point is, when this ride is going and folks are on it, it'll rotate every once in a while to the point where there are electricity sparks in the ceiling, little lightning bolts that pop, just like that, and it shows that it's generating power in here. This is the main turbine, if you will, for the entire station. Kind of similar to Watson's Tesla coiler, but with a little tweak. I'm gonna make the executive decision to not do the on-ride for that one. It's just 3 minutes of going in a circle. It's not the most interesting flat ride, but Ash needed a ride, so there you have it. Through this tunnel, we have the water viewing station, I guess, where you can kind of see the flecks of minerals that they're extracting from the hot springs that the entire station is built around. So that's the point of that blue tunnel for the connectivity. This is the entrance to the Escape from Sing Labs, which is actually the last coaster that we're gonna do. This is the cafeteria. The Escape from Sing Labs is the last coaster we're gonna do. It's kind of the main ride for the whole section, but on the loop, this is where it is. We can kind of take a peek in for now for the queue. It's pretty cool. It's definitely the most, I think, the most impressive ride, but we're gonna go on it a little later. Popping back outside, though, we get to take a great panoramic view of the other angle of the park and continue on towards the back half, which actually was never supposed to exist. I was supposed to stop building far before this ever existed, but I'm really glad I pushed through and continued to build. In here, we have the Echo Base from Kings Canyon, and they're the ones who are kind of processing all of the wastewater from the giant dam in the distance back there, and making sure that everything's clean as a whistle as it comes out and filters back into the rest of the park, into the rest of the zone. If we enter this ride, these are the Salvo Slammers. The interior, I know, leaves a lot to be desired, but a few spots kind of pull together, pull it off where there's decorations. The point of not decorating certain parts of these queues is because every pipe, every piece that I add is gonna cost me some level of my frame rate. And I would rather have people be able to go through it at least 30 frames than to have everything immaculately perfect when you're not really gonna see this all the time. Does that make sense? It's a huge kind of, I don't know. It's just tough to balance that when you're building a planet coaster. But either way, these are the buildings for these dueling coasters. They are two perfect mirror coasters that I had to build simultaneously to make sure that they fit together. There's one for Fuse, and on the other side, there's one for Maggie. Both of these coasters, again, are perfectly mirror images, so we're only gonna ride one. Maggie's side is literally identical to Fuse, except it's her face up there instead of Fuse's. But yeah, for now, let's get on this thing.
You come at your old mate Fuse, you best not miss. Hey, Mags?
Don't make me teach you respect, Walter, you walking moustache.
Let's get rowdy. Yee-haw!
Hush up, you got a bloody roller coaster ahead of yous. You know what they say? Mess with the bull and I'll trample you to death.
Oh, you got bloody smashed, mate.
Me? I put the war in Warlord.
And that's a bloody wrap, lads. Tucking and rolling out of the vehicle here.
Going off the beaten path here to show you the dam and then how the groundwater seeps in towards the Echo Station underneath the Salvo Slammers, and that's why they need to process it. It makes sense in my mind. I try to make everything somewhat realistic, somewhat like feasible, and give things a purpose in the park. But if we rotate around, we can continue down the main path in the back half of the park and continue on towards the Duo Showdown. This was a nightmare to build. I can't even describe it. I have so much respect now for people in this game who make dark rides consistently, but continuing in down the queue, the whole theme around this ride is that the riders are experiencing things from the point of view of Bangalore. Remember, drop, shock, and rock. Haha, IMC. It's a duo match, and she has Rampart as her teammate, and they're being hunted and chased by Caustic and Bloodhound. In this part of the queue, you can see Bangalore cinematic, and it's playing on the screen. I was pretty happy with this. I think it turned out super cool, super clean. And in the ride, you'll get to experience actually being in her shoes as she loses her teammate, as she has to fight Bloodhound and Caustic off herself, and then ultimately win the match. And I think it's really cool. So yeah, let's hop on this thing.
Only one squad left. It's gonna get loud.
Hey, suppose we win. Parent or dad? I'll just get a drink.
Let's go this way.
Yep.
Spotted. Double timing it. Taking fire.
I hear you.
Give him the chimney.
It got me. Nice shot, though.
Watching that spot.
Time to move out.
Enemy trap. Watch out. I'm hit. Spotted. Double timing it. Hostile, right here.
Have you prepared for your end?
Taking damage. Defending this area. Holding position. Gonna light him up. Throwing thermite. Giving him the chimney. Throwing arc star.
This is my favorite part. Breathing in. They downed me. They downed me.
Thank you.
No worries. You just owe me one.
Hell yeah. You are the Apex Champions.
Yes, that was on point, shooters.
I'm pretty happy with the way that that turned out. I don't know if you could tell, but it does get kind of desynced with the sound effect sometimes, and it's insanely frustrating, but I was really happy with the way that I was able to portray how terrifying it is to play against Bloodhound and Caustic. I think it turned out really well. I also love this view of the park. I like that double waterfall that I did. I think it's super sick, and on our right here, if we pause and back up a little bit, we have Gibraltar's Gyro. Gyro? I don't know how to say it. It's a spinny thing, is the point. This one, kinda, if you couldn't tell, is a bit of a throwaway ride. I couldn't think of anything else to do with Gibby. His abilities do not transfer well to any kind of amusement park ride, but I've got this one here. It's all set up and dedicated to him. So let's pop on this thing real quick. Alrighty, and continuing down, we can go back the way we came. Past this little plaza right here at the start, there's a little air vent, little mister to cool you off if it's a hot day. I hate being hot, so I tried to include a lot of shade and a lot of refreshment throughout the park. But anyways, we'll exit this zone, go back out to the main panoramic lake view coming out of the back half of the park. Turn this corner here and head on over to Revenant's Rocks and Ropes. I really wanted to do a coaster for Revenant at first, but the rope course was also an idea that I had that I really wanted to execute. And with Revenant's passive, being that he can climb higher than anybody else, he's the stalker, he can do whatever, it just fits so perfectly that this attraction should be for him. That you should be able to train alongside of him, I guess, if anybody would even want to, and learn how to stalk your prey just like Revenant does. So going across the course, there are these steps at first, and then a little lattice wall. I don't rock climb, I don't rope climb, I don't know what this shit is called, it just looked cool in my head. We get to climb across vertically here, pretty sure that would be a hell of a safety violation. Vertically climb up the rope, I'm not sure if any gamers could really do that. Another set of swings, and then across these swinging balls, and then across another little, the opposite of horizontal with the flat lattice. There we go. And then down a mini zip line into a cushion here where we get to bounce off of and go down the stairs. This will lead us to the rock wall where we can safely climb up with the extra little supports that are there to make sure that people don't die so that I don't get sued. Or Amber Rock doesn't get sued, not me. And if you make it to the top, you get to go across the lake spanning zip line, which if we go across the entire thing, we very slowly. I would hope that in real life it would be a little faster than this, at least as fast as you go down zip lines in Apex, because it's supposed to be one of Pathfinder's zip lines that he set there, because the zip line brings you all the way back over here where you bounce off that cushion again and end up in Pathfinder Plaza, which I thought was pretty fitting. And I really just wanted a reason to put in a giant zipline, but I think it worked out pretty well here. In real life, I'd have to walk all the way back across the park, of course. But for now, we can cheat and just fly back across the lake, not taking the zipline or another path. We get to see the dam ushering out water into the lake. We get to see another one of the geyser harvesters working its magic. And then we end up back on the path right outside of Revenant's Rocks and Ropes, and we get to head up to Octane's Extravaganza. This, so far, has been the Planet Coaster subreddit's favorite coaster. They loved it so much. I think it's really cool because it's super high energy. I think Octane's personality comes through perfectly in the coaster. I wanted it to feel like almost like a BMX course, motocross, whatever. Just something where it feels like you're doing stunts in a stadium and everybody's watching you. But if we go into this, the queue here, I'll take the first turn. This queue also isn't decorated perfectly. I tried to add pizzazz and flair where I could, but again, desperately trying to save my frame rate, so I'm not putting all the juice into every square inch of these queues, but you can see that the main station still looks pretty interesting. I wanted it to look pretty out there, pretty weird for Octane. Looking out at the glass, you can see the vents of his, what do you call that, his stimulant being processed. And then coming through the other side, we've got some supply bins, and then another view of the glass roof and the station. Looks pretty cool. This part of the queue, you can see out to Octane's coaster, which is pretty cool, the Extravaganza, and get a nice good look at what's in store for you. A lot of airtime hills, cool inversions, a lot of speed, G-forces, the whole shebang. This coaster's got it all, and I'm super excited to show you this one. So without further ado, let's get on it.
What's up? I'm the Jump Master, which should go without saying. Non Terre Plus Ultra! Olé! Aha! Ooh, that's gonna kick! Woo-hoo! I love this part! Yeah! Can you feel the speed? Yeah, baby! Vámonos! Booyah! Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go!
idea. Booyah! Rapidamente! Must go faster! Yeah! Epa! Must go faster! Woo-hoo! Go, 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 go! I love this part! Booyah! Whoa! What a rush! We kick ass! Good job, compadres. Oh, we should do that again. Only next time, even faster.
All right, hopefully you can see what I meant by how it captures Octane's personality. I think I chose the music pretty well. It took me forever to think of a song that matched his energy, but also had like the right tempo and the right feel. If you couldn't tell, if you didn't know, it's the instrumental to Eminem's by Blink-182. But I think it just like hypes everybody up. It's just, but it's also like a positive energy. It's not too metal or dark. Camera issue, sorry. But yeah, that was Octane's Extravaganza, super, super cool coaster, and now we get to push into the Dox Zone. This part is pretty cool. This is the part of the park that I think would be the probably like the highest volume, like the biggest congregation of people, because what's in front of you, the sci-fi cruiser with the wolf on the side, this is Loba's cruiser. And inside you can see the decor and everything, and then the restaurant is that little rabbit hole building right here, right up front. And this is Loba's Cruiser Cocina. It would be like the nice restaurant instead of all the stalls and stuff throughout the park. And if you saw from the lakeside view, the idea is that the actual restaurant is in the bridge, so you get to dine while you're out over the water. But obviously I can't do that. This is Lifeline's Looper, and it's a little tiny Zozo ride that's set in this building over here. Another kinda throwaway ride, because again, I don't know what the hell to do with Lifeline's abilities, you know, like what kind of ride to do, except for maybe riding alongside her care package as it drops from the troposphere, but I can't feasibly do that. So yeah, this is her Zozo, and let's back up and go on it real quick. And that'll be that, but under the control tower we have Sears Seeker Saloon. This is a backup plan. I originally wanted to do a whole pyrotechnic laser display for Sear, but it just didn't work out with the limitations of Planet Coaster. But in here we have our little robot butler serving some of my favorite beers. I actually don't drink Modelo all that often, but the other IPAs are all some of my favorites to any of the patrons of the park who would want them, with some other foods and things for people to enjoy. Stepping back out, we can see the engines of the cruiser. Ideally, you would want that to feel kind of cool and refreshing, but the mist effects just looked horrible stacked on top of each other, so I didn't do that. And pushing down towards the other side of the dock, we can see a little vista point. So this is just where people would stop to take photos with the big power plant in the background, some of the dock decorations, other things. I thought it made for a nice little photo op. But yeah, turning around the other way, this building off to the side here is just an information booth and an ATM. Nothing interesting in there. But this is probably my favorite building in the entire park. It's the Phase Runner monorail station on our left here. It's I was so happy with it. And then the Horizon gravity well is on the other side over yonder. But yeah, right up here with the phase runner, the cables swooping down, and then I put these nice little cloth banners over it to make it look more interesting. And you can see the monorail parked there right now. That's how some guests get here. And then the station up top, not decorated inside, of course, just saving the frame rate again. But I just love all the colors over here. I think it looks really, really cool. And this waterfall was actually my girlfriend's idea. One of her coolest contributions to this park. She's great with landscaping. You can see the water running down there, going back to the lake. But over here, we have Horizon's Gravity Well. This, I think, was the first... No, second flat ride I built in the park. Also, just trying to give it some sort of function. The point of this ride is that you sit in Horizon's Gravity Well, the machine will tilt up, and when it gets into the right position, it activates a bunch of pumps that extract minerals and water from the lake and then pump it through the giant pipes that are underneath it to the cruiser and the other things that need it. So it's kind of like using a centrifuge to pull a bunch of water out and pump it elsewhere, which I thought was a pretty neat idea. This building is also, hopefully clearly, modeled after the architecture in Stormpoint. So that's the aesthetic I was going for here. The roofs were very hard to make, but for now, let's go on this ride. Alrighty, and now we get to go back across the lake to that main ride to finish up our tour of Amber Rock. This ride is a little complicated. It has like a whole story to it, so let me break it down for you really quickly. The main characters, of course, are Wraith, Crypto, and Mirage. They all form a team to help get you out of a definitely deathly situation. If we pop into the ride here, we can see that we're in an IMC kind of laboratory slash facility. You can look down and see the new riders coming back and into the station, kind of like Space Mountain in Disneyland. But if we continue down, we can see different little classrooms and laboratories where the IMC is doing studies. The point of this place is to develop warp technology or phase technology for Titans. Because Wraith can phase, but they're like, okay, well, what if a Titan itself could phase? And there's a whole risk of the pilot desynchronizing from the Titan and them fusing together, which would kill the pilot horrifically. And everybody in the line is like an unwilling test subject. There's like a whole audio file that explains it, but I'm just doing the summary to keep it moving. But yeah, in the line here, you would be taught what was going to happen to you, and you'd be, you know, totally scared out of your mind and introduced to the story of the ride. But down here, we're already at the station, so we can just pop right onto the ride and get into the action of Escape from Sing Labs, which is the signature ride of Amber Rock. Online. Primary dispatch, phase trial 235 is away. Subject vitals are green across the board, heart rate's a tad elevated for some reason. Could be that they suspect something, but if they do, it's Jerry's fault.
Hey, what?
And they won't be around to tell anyone anyway, so we're good. Alright, here we go. Dispatching into Phase Runner in T-minus 5, 4, 3, whoa, what the hell was that? security? What's
going
on?
Portal placed. Follow the tunnel.
Oh, they got wrecked. They're not coming back from that.
Check your tech. That EMP could have knocked it out.
What you're noticing is my sparkling personality.
Focus.
Rafe, you know I've got this.
This'll work. Activating hardware reboot.
All right, let's do this.
Whoa. No. I lost control. The sled's diverting. Jerry, hit the e-stop. I'm calling Dr. Fing. No.
Pay attention, gang. Today will be one of those experiences you'll sit back and say, oh yeah, I remember that.
Focus. Just 10 seconds.
Don't tell me what to do. But yeah, okay.
Everything is shutting down, but there's an audio file downloading. How do I cancel this? I don't get it.
You got bamboozled. Look at you.
Here we go. Ready up.
It's time to take this spin for a ride. With the ride, we're on the wheels off this thing. Let's go.
I haven't seen target dummies smarter than you,
old man. See ya.
And with that, our tour of Amber Rock is complete. It's taken me over a year and a half to design and build all of this, and I'm so happy with how it turned out. I'm gonna open the park up to guests now, which is gonna turn my game into a slideshow. Not joking, this is what it looks like in real time, but I want to show it in action as I rattle off a few more things. First, thank you so much for watching all the way to the end if you did. It means the world to me that you were kind enough to give me this much of your time to look at my project. Second, if you have Planet Coaster, you can visit Amber Rock yourself. I used almost all of the DLCs to bring it to life and a lot of custom content, but you can still visit the park without buying any of the DLC packs. You just won't be able to save the park as your own if you make tweaks or adjustments. Third, my main goal with this park was to inspire at least 2 Apex players on the planet to take a crack at designing their own parks, or just to inspire them to start playing sandbox games in general. To help with that, I'll be uploading everything that I can to my Steam Workshop page. That way, you can use my assets to make your own Apex park if you want to. It should cut the workload in like a third for you. And finally, if you liked what you saw here, please consider subscribing. This is my first video really showing off what I can do in sandbox games, but my usual videos are focused around game discussion and talking about how certain games could have been way better. My next video, though, will be the second in a series I'm hoping to do where I teach you everything I know about a certain sandbox building game. I'll be getting into detail about creating a believably unbelievable park in Planet Coaster to help anyone who's interested bring their ideas to life. Again, thank you so much for watching, and hopefully, I'll see you in the next one. Bye!